June 28th, 2024. I sat at my computer with itch.io open in my browser and my mouse hovering over the save button. At this point, I had already exported my game at least 5 or 6 times. Each time, finding some small thing that I wanted to change before uploading it as my first finished game. A year before, I knew nothing about game development, and to be honest, I still felt like that. But still, I sat there, going over every line of code in my head to try and figure out if it was really time to press that button. Was it really finished? Did I really make a game? This is a shelf. And so is this. These shelves have been sitting in this room for the past couple months, not on the wall, just in the corner, waiting for me to put them up. At any point during the past couple months, I could have made the decision to do it, and within minutes, they would be up. But I had something holding me back. What if I don't like where I put them? What if I put them up and they turn out to be in a spot that's not perfect? This isn't just a one-off issue, though. To some degree, this is the same excuse that holds me back from most of my goals that I haven't completed yet. If you have any goals that you want to complete in the near or distant future, feel free to drop them in the comments so we can hold each other accountable. I don't like New Year's resolutions because even though it's a year-long time frame to complete the goals, it still puts a time limit on me. If I don't complete my resolutions by the end of the year, I am afraid I would get the feeling that I failed. And it's for this reason that I've never made a New Year's resolution before, or even monthly goals. But sitting in this room, staring at these shelves in the corner over there, I realized something. I don't need to make any resolutions or monthly goals in order to fail them. At the end of the day, it doesn't matter if the thing that I didn't do is written down anywhere or not, so why am I so against writing my goals down? Especially because I know from experience that when I do keep track of my tasks, I have a much higher chance of following through. This is why I've made the decision that for the first time in my life, I'm going to be writing my goals down for the year. And I think you should consider it too. If you're anything like me and you've never liked the idea of writing things down for fear of failure, I think a simple perspective shift might change that. You see, all this time, whenever I thought about writing down what do I want to accomplish that month or that year, I saw it as a way to track my failures. At the end of that time period, what I would be left with is a list of things that I potentially haven't finished. But whether I wrote them down or not, those things that aren't finished are still there. But at least when they're written down, I know what they are. And if I know what they are, I can keep track of them. When I reach a goal, I want there to be no question about whether it's complete or not. I like things that are easily measured, like learn 10 songs on piano, or have a portfolio of 150 original recorded sounds, which are 2 goals on my own list, by the way. With these goals, I'll be able to know exactly when they're complete and when I'll be able to check them off, which is why I prefer these instead of something like get better at playing piano, which how would I know when I've improved enough to be able to check it off my list? If you're making goals, write them in a way so there's no question about whether they're complete, because it gives you something concrete to work towards. Another one of my goals is to make 6 games this year. This sounds really daunting at first, but games don't always have to be this overscoped project I've spent months planning out. In this channel's Discord, I make a fun little game dev challenge every month for people to practice their skills, and the most recent one was to make a small tic-tac-toe game with a twist. It was really cool to see the different ideas from everyone, and take a look at this. This was developed in a really short time frame for our game, and it's really fun. Seeing this was incredibly inspiring, and it makes me want to push myself for next year, including finishing the game that I'm working on that also stemmed from a Discord challenge. And don't be afraid to throw in some unconventional goals as well. Since I'm learning game development, being sure to make time to play games is important as well, and I have some games that have been on my backlog for a while. It may sound like a weird goal, but I even have Ocarina of Time on my list to finish this year. Goals like this help me to stay inspired for both game dev and the rest of my goals. As I'm writing my goals, I'm trying to write them in a way to keep me motivated. I really enjoy the feeling of checking things off, knowing that they're complete. And because of that, I'm structuring my goals in a way to give myself plenty of opportunities to check things off along the way, not just when one of the main goals are complete. Take my piano goal, for instance. This is an important goal for me because I want to be able to make original music for my future game dev projects. And so I want to get better at playing the piano to help with that. To keep me motivated, instead of just writing the big goal to learn 10 songs, I have a main goal written at the top, which is to learn 10 songs, and then I have a checkbox for every song that I learn along the way, with space for me to write the name of each song that I learn. This will allow me to easily see the progress on my goals, and it gives me a little bit of dopamine each time I get a little bit closer to one of my main goals. I structured my goal about recording sounds in the same way, only I'm not going to write 150 checkboxes, so I structured them in groups of 10 instead. The most important thing about all of this is to give yourself grace if you can't complete everything on your list. You're never going to know exactly what the next year or month will entail, and things can get in the way of our goals, but writing down your goals can at least help keep you oriented in the right direction. I mentioned earlier that the reason why I've never done this before is because I didn't want to look back and see a bunch of unachieved goals on my list. But the truth is that even if I was only able to achieve 10% of my goals, those 10% are still things that I didn't have completed last year. And now they are. 10% might seem like a failure on the surface, but in reality, it's still an improvement, and it shows that I'm moving in the right direction. When I finally finished my game, it was an amazing feeling because of the work that I put into it. It took so long and caused quite a few headaches while working on the many bugs, but all of that was worth it for the feeling I got when I was finally able to call it complete. Looking back, I want to create more of those moments. I want to make more opportunities for myself to feel that same feeling with each and every one of the goals that I've written down. Each one gives me the chance to feel that again, and with them here on paper, it makes it a little easier for me to hold myself accountable for them. Instead of being hidden, pushed out of sight in the corner of the room where I never look, they're here with me, ready to be another reason to celebrate. You can start now by writing down your goal in the comments on this video so we can hold each other accountable and share what works for us. I love seeing the goals that other people make, and it can even give me ideas for my own goals as well. Also, if you're looking for a game dev Discord where we all keep each other motivated, share what we're working on, and get feedback, feel free to join with the link in the description. I'll see you over there, and stay motivated and keep learning.